नित्यानंदेश्वर सदाशिवसमारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वर्यादिशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरा। आई वेलकम यू ऑल विथ मई लव एंड रेस्पेक्ट्स। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, sarvangyapita yajamans and swamis and mahans from Niranjani and Nirvani Akada. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome everyone who is sitting with us through Nityananda TV and two-way video conferencing in more than hundreds of centers, practically every country, in every time zone, in every continent. At least few thousands. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Life beyond limits, listen. The body in which you are residing, which is the center for your existence or your perception of existence, evolved step by step, like cell, amoeba, growing to the level of fish. Amoeba to fish is a pure physical growth, nothing more. From fish to monkey is physical and mental, both breakthroughs together. Understand? When fish started feeling, just body alone is not enough to celebrate its existence. Life is too much, body is too little. It developed a tool called mind. And next level bodies, the mind developed more and more apps and tools, if I have to talk in the software language. More and more tools and apps started developing. And at the level of monkey, beings have felt just body and mind is not enough. Universe is too much to enjoy and celebrate. Just body and mind is too little. Then beings have started developing a new component, ability to reflect consciousness. Understand? When monkey started standing with two legs, the speed of the blood flow, not the quantity, the speed of the blood flow to the brain became less. So the brain started developing very subtle grooves through which it can perceive without thinking. Understand, the first perception without thinking happened is gratitude. That is why whenever you feel gratitude, the whole brain becomes active. Gratitude is the first perception without thinking. Thought currentless experience. The first experience, thought currentless, is gratitude. Listen carefully. From amoeba, cell to fish, is pure physical growth. From fish to monkey, physical and mental growth. You will be surprised. The first mental action is pornography. The perception of sex without using the body is the source of mind. That is why mind is such a torture. Beginning itself is inauspicious. The first step is inauspicious, so inauspicious. I am not saying sex is inauspicious. I am saying thought currents about it is inauspicious. From fish to monkey, body and mind breakthrough means beyond body, something was built. Then from monkey to man, beyond body and mind, something started getting perceived. The perception, which is beyond thought currents, have started developing from monkey to man. That is what I call ability to reflect consciousness in the system. First time, the human beings have reached a space saturation of all different permutation combination of consciousness. Listen. Let me define what I mean by consciousness. It is ability to reflect, perceive beyond body and thought currents. Even if your thought currents are switched off, your body is put to rest, you have ability to perceive your existence. That's what I call consciousness. It can be in dream state, waking state, various states, deep sleep state. Even in deep sleep state, you do continuously exist even though your body and mind is switched off. That is why when you come back, you have a consistent ability to connect with what you left. You just don't get into the delete mode. No, it's not that control delete. No. It was only a break. It was not breakdown. Your consciousness, jagrat, sapna, sushupti, turiya, turiya, atita. In Agama, it is 5 into 5, 25 states of consciousness. In Vedic tradition, God is embodiment of 5 action. Srishti, sthiti, vinasa, throbhava, anugraha, creation, maintenance, rejuvenation, and lot of delusion and liberation. Listen, from amoeba to fish, physical growth, physical breakthrough. From fish to monkey, physical and mental breakthrough. Mind means ability to perceive more than body. And from monkey to man, conscious breakthrough. When I use the word conscious here, I am using in the meaning of ability to perceive even in the absence of body and mind. that ability is only available in human body. In the human body, only that ability is developed. Ability to reflect consciousness. Sometimes you are a flat mirror, sometimes concave mirror, sometimes all kinds of mirror. The village circus shows, if you are gone, you know. You will be seeing yourself 20 upside downs. I don't know whether it is popular in Western countries. In Indian countries, all village shows it will be there. I think it is universal because everyone wants to see themselves in all crooked form. So in every village show, you will find these mirror stalls. You become mirror. Your ability to mirror consciousness happened in the physical body, human body. Listen. Only when the fish felt, I think, body alone is too little to enjoy life, breakthrough into mind started happening. When monkey felt, mind alone, body mind alone is too little to experience life, the conscious breakthrough started happening. It is time. Human beings have started feeling body, mind, consciousness alone is too little to enjoy universe. Tremendous depression, boredom, tiredness, teenage suicide, drugs. Understand, in next 5 years, the biggest problem of the humanity is not going to be HIV or terrorism. No. If you think terrorism, HIV, all that is going to be a big problem, no, you are wrong. It is boredom going to be the biggest problem. Human beings are going to see every alternative. Solutions. Change language, change country, changing spouses, changing husband or wife is an old fashion. Changing your own gender is going to become new fashion. Suddenly, one fine morning you decide to change your gender is going to be new fashion. But all this also will be out of fashion within 5 years. Human beings will reach the peak of boredom in next 5 years. The biggest problem human beings are going to face is boredom, because we have reached a space where we all know body, mind, consciousness which we have is too little. We need a breakthrough. The collective seeking that we need a breakthrough. Answer for that collective seeking, we need a breakthrough. Answer for that collective seeking. Answer for that collective boredom, solution for that collective boredom, answer for that collective seeking is this Life Beyond Limits program. Understand, it is time. Let's have super conscious breakthrough from man to Sadashiva. You have grown from amoeba to fish, fish to monkey, monkey to man. Now it is time from man to Sadashiva. I am not going to use the word man to God or man to divine. All those words are too poor. I am very clear. I do not want to dilute the goal. That is why I use the word man to Sadashiva. Sadashiva is not the God as Western religions describe. He is beyond that. God is only generator, operator, destroyer. Sadashiva does two things more. Generator, operator, destroyer, deluder and liberator. Srishti Stiti Vinasa Trobhava Anugraha. So the very concept of God in the Western religions is poor man's version of Sadashiva. Sorry, I am not interested in hurting you, but what I am saying is truth. I am not interested in hurting you. What I am saying is truth. I am not interested in hurting anybody. I am interested in giving a breakthrough to humanity. That's my only interest. I am not interested in destroying any belief system, philosophy, theology, religion established. I am just going to raise the scale. Whoever survives, survive. I am taking the whole thing to the next level. Sanatana Hindu Dharma is capable, I should say, most powerful religious tradition which is capable of giving a superconscious breakthrough to humanity. So I have collected methods and science from the Vedas and Agamas, presenting it to all of you to give you the experience of life beyond limits. Understand? I am going to initiate you experientially to manifest extraordinary powers to make you understand superconscious breakthrough is possible, software is successful. I am not a magician and I am not interested to become one. I am neither logician nor magician. Logicians are more bogus than magicians. I am neither logician nor magician. I am neither logical nor magical. Listen, I'll give you a simple understanding how superconscious breakthrough can be sustained in your system once I initiate you. For initiation, nothing is required. It is just you being available to me. Are you saying, yes, please do it? Nothing more is required. That yes also has ethics. It's not that if you don't give yes, I can't do, but I don't do as ethics. It is just ethical. No entry boats of Indian roads. There is nobody to watch and stop you. It is just you follow ethics. Listen carefully. Once I initiate you and give you a conscious breakthrough, sustaining it, for that you may need little understanding. See, the software with which you are operating, contains certain limitations because the fellows who wrote the software itself could imagine only this much. They can't perceive which they don't know. Your father and mother can never teach you. You can be without sleep. But I am already successful without creating any physical or mental disorder. Drastically reducing the quality of sleep and increasing the quantity of sleep in my balasans under the controlled conditions. Your parents can never teach you this because they themselves do not know it is possible. The softwares with which your body and mind is operating may not have faults but has a lot of limitations. If you are in a listening space enough, I will tell you there is even fault. The software with which your body and mind and consciousness is functioning has a lot of limitations. The cognitions you carry has a lot of limitations. The first step human being need to learn is manifesting powerful cognitions in every step of your life is authenticity. Manifesting powerful cognitions in every step of your life, whether it is about your wealth, health, relationships, energy, intelligence, anything you have in your life, manifesting powerful cognitions about it. For example, you can look at your life and say, wow, so many years I managed so many problems, then I can be really through my whole life. If I can manage this much, why not anything further? This is powerful cognition. Or you can also manifest, I am already tired, feeling heavy. What am I going to do? If something more comes tomorrow, day after tomorrow, you can manifest that cognition also. Going on manifesting powerful cognitions about everything is authenticity. About wealth, life, intelligence, health, body, knowledge, good, bad, fears, hopes, desires, life, relationships, about everything. Master is a message from Cosmos. Software update available. You can say, do it now or not now, remind me later, remind me in the night. You can press anything. I am just a pop-up saying software is updated, ready. Ability to go on manifesting powerful cognitions about your money. I made so much. Only the first rupee is difficult. You see, first crore you have to make it with your blood. The first crore will make the second crore just using your sweat. And the second crore will make the third crore. You don't even have to give your blood or sweat, just spit. That is the way life is. If you decide to live, or you can say, this one crore itself is paining my back. What am I going to do? You can manifest powerless cognitions. You have a freedom. Understand? Freedom is not choices in front of you. It is ability to develop your will persistence with the whole universe. Listen, I'll repeat. Freedom is not choices in front of you. This car, that car, that car, whether this cell phone, that cell phone, that cell phone, or this food, that clothes. It is ability to command the universe with your will persistence. Freedom is to ability to dictate universe with your will persistence, not choices. Choices is baby's freedom. If you are given choice, you are diverted. Understand, whenever media makes some big issues, whenever media makes big issues out of something, don't look at that. Look at what they are trying to divert you from. Look at what they are trying to divert you from. Same way, whenever society gives you the choice and freedom, look at what they are trying to divert you from. Look at what they are trying to divert you from. Your ability to dictate the universe is freedom, not your ability to pick up the 10 items they are showing in front of you. The worst conspiracy done against humanity is you have been taught choices are freedom. No. Will persistence is freedom. Will persistence is freedom. The whole humanity is going to collapse because they believed choices are freedom. Now choices are over. In 5 years, you are going to have softwares. By hooking yourself to it, you can download language, arts. You can change gender, just like walk in and walk out. It will not be months together or years together. Walk in as male and walk out as female, or walk in as female and walk out as male. It'll all be within few hours. You are going to have the choices to the level where you will be terrorized. Understand? You will be terrorized with choices. Then you will understand choice is not freedom. Will persistence is freedom. Will persistence is freedom. If you have been taught choice is freedom, the person who taught either is stupid or part of the conspiracy. If you believe, either you are fool or deluded. Will persistence is freedom. Your ability to persist with your will is freedom, not the choices in front of you. The mentality, the society built on choices or freedom, is already collapsing. I can see in front of my eyes the country which consumes more than 60% of the resources of the planet Earth is 63% depressed. 3% chronically means can't even get out of their home and 63% can go and manage their day-to-day activity, but depressed, clinically depressed. 60% of the resources of the planet Earth is consumed by a country which is 66% depressed, 3% chronic, and 63% manageable clinical depression. That is why I am saying the thought current, lifestyle, civilization built choices or freedom is collapsing. It is Varanasi answer, not New York. It is Varanasi answer, not New York. I'm not against New York. I just want you to know the thought current, choices or freedom, is childish, outdated, over. Human beings are facing terrorizing choices. Understand? Our biggest problem is not going to be lack of resources. It is going to be terrorizing choices, where you are not just going to be bombarded with choices, you are going to be terrorized by choices. Will persistence is freedom, not choices. Choices of food, pleasures, clothes, cars, the way you stay, whether off-the-grid constructions or 9-star, 11-star hotels. Thank God I was brought up in billion-star hotels under sky, where I could enjoy billion stars. The way you stay, the way you travel, the way you style yourself up, the way you love, the way you have sex, the way you romance, the way you die and where you have your cremation, everything, you are going to have terrorizing choices. I am not using the word, you will be given choices or you will be bombarded with choices. You will be literally terrorized with choices. But that is not freedom. That is not freedom. Will persistence. Ability to command the universe is persistent. The will persistence is freedom. Ability to command the universe is freedom. Listen. The fundamental principle, first principle for life beyond limits is knowing the software with which you are operating as faults and limitations. I don't know how many of you know about this ransom software which is going around and attacking the computers all over the world, and it can be decrypted only if you pay some ransom. How many of you know? Cancer is medical ransom software. It is business, not disease. Cancer is a business, not disease. Diabetes 2 is business, not disease. Diabetes 2 is penny ransom software. Cancer is pounds ransom software. That's all. They are not disease. They are businesses. Understand, it is time. You do realize that the software with which you are operating has some faults and limits. Deciding to manifest powerful cognitions continuously about everything. Immediately you say, I don't know how to manifest powerful cognition. I can't practice, I am tired and bored, Swamiji. Even about this, start manifesting powerful cognitions. If you can find your problem, that itself is a proof you can solve it. Among the billions, it is only few thousands are awakened to this truth. If this truth falls into my ears, Sadashiva is graceful and compassionate enough, he will make that as an experience in my heart. If he can reach this to my ears, can't he reach this to my heart? If he is reaching to my ears, he is going to reach it to my heart. If he is reaching it to my ears, he is going to reach it to my heart. Otherwise, why in the 7 billion, only in these few thousand, I am also part. You might have been here. Due to various reasons, maybe your girlfriend pushed you, or your mother pushed you, your friend pushed you, your family pushed you, or you saw the flyer somewhere. Whatever may be the reason, you are here. But now understand the purpose why you are here. Reasons are not purposes. Reason may be different. Now you need to know the purpose. Purpose is to start manifesting powerful cognitions about life, about everything in which you are stuck. Powerful cognitions are not positive thinking. No. Thinking itself is stupid. How can there be something positive about it? Thinking itself is negative. How can there will be something positive about it? Powerful cognition means consciousness breaking the limits of body-mind. Positive thinking means you have to logically practice it. Practice is four-letter word in our Sangha? No. Practice means your logic trying to take over your depth. Cognitive shift means your depth dictating to your logic. Practice means you think of integrity and say, from tomorrow, I am going to practice integrity, 4 o'clock yoga. And 3:57, the alarm clock gets a big bang, dung. And then you curse everyone in the planet Earth. Who made the alarm? who brought it to your bed, who asked you to wake up. Everyone gets their share of curse. And then you don't know what happened. When you are again awake, it's already 8:30. This is what is practice. Stupid's practice. The stupid's gurus teach practices. Mysore Road does not teach practice. It teaches cognitive shift. For practice, choose another road. For cognitive shift, choose Mysore Road. I am not interested in teaching you any practice, no. I am interested in teaching you cognitive shift. Depth, you are depth, you are depth. Only that need to decide. All practices are so-called teachers trying to cover their ignorance, their inability to give you solution. They may be super capable in analyzing your problem. That does not mean they can give you solutions. Like psychiatry, psychoanalysis. They have amazing technical terms. If you go to a psychoanalyst or psychiatric psychoanalyst and all that, in 1 year you will become a doctor. You know all technical terms of analyzing your problem. Conscious, subconscious, unconscious, supraconscious. You can take sessions and lessons and classes, but you don't know the solution. Because even your doctor doesn't know. Ability to analyze problem does not mean they have a solution. Diagnostic centers are different, hospitals are different, surgery theaters are different. Capacity to do surgery is different. Understand? The first fundamental principle I wanted you to understand now. Go on manifesting powerful cognitions about everything in which you are stuck in your life. Sit for a few minutes and pen down all the powerless cognitions in which you are stuck, the memories which puts you in powerlessness, whether remembrance of money, remembrance of relationship, remembrance of your health, a remembrance of yourself. That is, I think, the worst thing. Nobody wants to remember themselves. That is why they try to go for vacation. They jump here, they jump there, they go there, they go here. Unfortunately, they carry themselves with it, with you, with them. What to do? How much you will put the camera all the time outside? What a beautiful destination, vacation place. But inside it is saying, no, no, I am not interested. Whatever remembrance or thought currents puts you in powerlessness, pen down. Manifesting powerless cognitions is inauthenticity. Manifesting powerful cognitions is authenticity. Positive thinking is so-called self-development. I am not interested in it. Because that needs to be practiced here. manifesting powerful cognition is totally different level. It is not in the thinking level. It is in the superconscious level. Superconscious intervening in your style of existing is what I call conscious shift, cognitive shift. Your intelligence intervening in the style of your thinking is positive thinking. Your superconsciousness intervening in the style of your existence is cognitive shift. It's different level. If I have to give you more precise difference, in positive thinking you need to practice, in cognitive shift you just need to declare. In positive thinking you don't need initiation, Shaktipada. In cognitive shift, Shaktipada starts the whole thing. In positive thinking there is always negative thinking. In the superconscious breakthrough there is no negative superconscious breakthrough. In positive thinking it is trial and error. It is in the superconscious breakthrough, the cognitive shift, it is trial and success. The first step I want you to do, pin down all the powerless cognitions with which you are stuck. It can be discontent about yourself, self-doubt, ideas of right, wrong, good, bad, health, money, job, career, wealth, beauty, relationships, anger, anxiety, inability to handle yourself, whatever, whatever, whatever it may be. Pen down. I'll teach you to have a breakthrough. Not just teach you, I'll initiate you to have a superconscious breakthrough, to manifest powerful cognitions and manifest at least one extraordinary Shakti of Sadashiva. Shaktis are given as a gift to encourage you when you decide to manifest powerful cognitions. When you decide to become divine, when you decide to become Sadashiva, Shaktis are beautiful roses shared. Shaktis are nothing but welcome rose to Kailasa. When you enter into Kailasa, decide to become Sadashiva, the welcome rose is Shaktis. So take few minutes to crack all the powerless cognitions of your inner space.
Please take a few minutes to pen down all the powerless cognitions with which you are stuck. It can be discontentment about yourself, ideas about good, bad, powerless cognitions you have about health, wealth, job, career, relationships, anger, anxiety, inability to handle yourself, whatever it may be. There may be a lot of other things which we have not listed it here. Please take a few minutes to pen down.
Please settle down. Now we'll enter into the solution. Listen very carefully. Manifesting powerful cognitions, whether about your health or relationships or yourself. Because you are a juncture of ultimate and lowest, you can go back, go down. You have a freedom to get back to amoeba. You have a right to become Sadashiva. You have both. You can manifest more and more powerful cognitions. It is not practice, it is declaration. Listen. Again, I am reminding you, it is not practice, it is declaration. Practice is not worth. Any practice is not worth practicing. All practice is only logic level. It is declarations, means your depth, whole depth understanding and moving towards it. That comes only from the space of completion. I'll repeat the essence. Listen. I'll repeat the essence. You have moved from amoeba to fish, fish to monkey, monkey to man. Now it is time to move from man to Sadashiva. Just the sheer reason why you should move from the space of man to Sadashiva, because you feel that you lived enough with this present available body, mind, and states of consciousness. Understand? The loneliness, depression, boredom, tiredness you feel can never be cured by anything else other than having a superconscious breakthrough. It is time to have a breakthrough. It is not time to have a band-aid. Band-aid and fairness creams are not going to solve your problem. You need bone marrow transplant. Band-aids and fairness creams are not going to solve the issue. No. You need bone marrow transplantation. I may say even bone transplantation. I may say actually whole thing transplantation. So decision to manifest powerful cognition, whatever you wrote now, which puts you in powerlessness, the same situation, if you decide to manifest powerful cognition, what kind of thought currents you will have, you will release, you will manifest about that situation. What is the powerful cognition you may want to have? Whether, don't have the doubt, will I be able to have it? That is my job. Making you have it is my job. If I give you the opportunity, what kind of a powerful cognition you will have it, pen down that. That's all I'm asking you. For example, about your health. Oh. It's after all my body. I decide what goes on in me. So I can decide to be healthy. My decision has to become reality tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Time doesn't matter. The moment I decide, it's only a question of time. And ultimately it does not matter. After you become healthy, you will not even remember how long you have been sick. How many of you understand this? After you become healthy, you don't even remember how many days you have been sick. So, friend's house is always near. Because after you reach, you will never remember how long you traveled. It is never far away. All the powerful cognitions you want to have about each subjects you may have powerless cognition, may not have powerless cognition about it. But the powerful cognition you want to have about everything in life, please spend down for a few minutes. So I can program your inner software with your powerful cognitions. You order the specifics, I'll write the software and feed it. It is just taking specifics from you now. Blessings. Blessings. Be blessed. Be blessed.